Hey friends, you know customers run their SAP landscapes on some of the biggest VMs in Azure, such as the M-Series VM and HLIs. Running these systems in the cloud, they need an easy way to monitor them and visually correlate telemetry data between the various parts like infrastructure server, cluster, databases, etc. Syeda Persia Aziz is here to show us how they can use Azure Monitor for SAP Solutions to deploy monitoring resources and collect end-to-end telemetry all in one place. Today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Syeda Persia Aziz and we're going to learn about Azure Monitor for SAP Solutions. I have to confess, I don't know anything about SAP other than it's big and maybe it's scary or maybe it's not scary.
Wow, SAP, I wouldn't call it scary. It is a large multinational company, and they are experts of developing business processes software, mainly like enterprise software. And they have like a software suite of various scales, and some are like really large and so large that when customers use Azure for their SAP environment, they have to use the like largest of VM SKUs. And also, like some, if they choose to use bare metal, those are like really large beefy machines, like HLI or VLI, things like that.
So maybe I was scared because someone told me that they use Godzilla scale VMs, like you said, the biggest VMs that we sell.
That's true. Yeah, that's true. Those are Godzilla scale VMs, like the M series VMs, like the largest VM that we offer. Yeah, they have to use that. For like a lot of their applications, actually, and for databases, for example, also.
Okay. So when you're running these systems in the cloud, you need a way to monitor them and be able to manage that, all that information coming out of it. Telemetry, there's the infrastructure server, the clusters, the databases, their in-memory system. That sounds kind of overwhelming. Maybe you could show me the architecture.
Sure. Yes. So first of all, what we built here, which we call Azure Monitor for SAP Solutions, it's an Azure-native monitoring solution for our customers who run their SAP workload on Azure. So this is like a high-level overview of how it looks like. So customer can go to an Azure portal because this product is available in Azure Marketplace, and they can request one on our service. We'll deploy the solution, the Azure Monitor for SAP solution in their subscription. And you can see that there is like a managed resource group, which contains all the resources that really power up the solution. And the resources talk to like several source systems to collect telemetry from them. So quickly, I would show how it looks like, the create experience looks like for this one. So like I said, this is available on Azure Marketplace. And to create a monitor, you don't have to like put in a lot of information here. It's just the basics like subscription, resource group, and then you give it a name, region. One key thing here is like a virtual network and subnet that I showed here. So this subnet will give the monitor ability to connect to the source system that the user wants to monitor. And also there is an option to share data with Microsoft support. And the reason is that like there were two reasons behind this product when we started it. One was, of course, like enable the customer to monitor their SAP system. Another one is like from Azure so that we can support our customers better when there is an issue or basically have some data so that we can troubleshoot better and in an easier fashion. Next, like after you put in the basics, you can add more providers here. So I'll talk about providers in a little bit. It's a key concept for Azure Monitor for SAP Solutions, then tags, and then you can review, create. So for the interest of time, I'm not going to create one right now, but I'll just quickly go through one which is already deployed. It is like, so you can see this is the Manage Experience page. You can see the subnet name and the managed resource group that I showed in the architecture diagram. And one key thing is like LogNX workspace, which contains all the raw data that we collect. And we do like come with, we do like provide the customers with some default visualizations. But if the customers want to have their own visualization and like custom alerting, they can always do so by accessing the raw data directly in Logonus Workspace. So the key things that I want to talk about is providers. So what is exactly a provider? A provider is a component that collects telemetry from a specific source type. So for example, here in this monitor, you can see that there are three kinds of providers. So Microsoft SQL Server, High Availability Cluster, and then SAP HANA. So I'll just go through the workbooks quickly, to which will give you the visualization of the data. So you can see that the SAP HANA provider is monitoring a multi-node, like four-node system here, and it shows all the status, quick snapshot of the CPU, memory, disk, and utilization. So if you want to take a look at the utilization closely, you can come here and you can see the CPU, and you can also see the memory. You can see that there is a drop in the memory utilization at this point of time. So these are all useful information for users who use HANA.
Now, then if I may, what is HANA? That's their memory database. That's the heart of SAP.
Yes. So it's HANA is a large scale like in memory database that a lot of customers use as their backend database server for their SAP system, and it's an in memory database. Like I said, it's so large, and the memory is really large. Like I'm talking terabytes here. The memory is that large. And usually like they handle a critical workload. So that's why like the data is actually loaded in the memory.
I see. So monitoring these things is absolutely essential. The load, the cache hits, all the things that we're seeing in your dashboard here.
Yes. Yes. Those are absolutely critical. And also, one thing HANA does is, it takes backup of the logs. You can also do like data backups. So you can see, and this is another very useful information for the customer as well. You can see the backup size and the duration, and then although you can see individual information of each backup here as well. So this is all HANA, and if you have like replication enabled, which is the HANA system replication, then you can see that here. So for example, there was an error with the replication, and this error shows up. And the user will see this and take action, take appropriate action to fix those. So this is one of the providers, the SAP HANA providers. Another kind of provider I would like to talk about is a high availability cluster. What it means is when you have two nodes and there's a high availability cluster set up, meaning one is primary, another is secondary. So if the primary is down, the secondary takes over. This is another very important use case for our customers. And then you can see that there are two nodes, they're all up and running, and you can check the status of the resources that really sets up the high availability part here. So I will talk to this part again. So let's talk about Microsoft SQL Server. This is another kind of provider that we have. So as of now, you saw telemetry regarding cluster health and then also utilization of the infrastructure. Here, we do show infrastructure related telemetry here, but you can also see like statistics. And then you can see things like, say, top 10 SQL statements that were
on. Oh, wow. Yeah, okay. So hang on. This is interesting because I thought that SAP would be an opaque application, and we would be looking at just the infrastructure details, CPU and memory and disk access. But suddenly now we're in a different provider. I'm hearing you say that this SQL Server provider is choosing to give us additional context, and you're actually seeing popular hot SQL queries in the system. Is that up to the provider to make those decisions?
Yeah, it's up to the provider. So what I showed here, like you have three providers here. So the HANA provider here, kind of like that we wrote that, is very much focused towards infrastructure. But if there is a requirement where the like the customer wants to see some application telemetry, and then we can write a provider for them and just plug it in here. It's just that it's more like a framework. So as we have like more needs to do like more monitoring on different kind, we can write providers of that specific type and just plug it in to their existing monitor to like basically extend their monitoring ability.
That's really powerful because all of this is being built on top of the Azure Monitor infrastructure, which Azure uses to monitor itself. So yeah. That'll scale and you don't have to worry about that. It's monitoring as a service. And then, wow, I mean, look at all the data that you're seeing here on your dashboard.
Yeah. It's pretty cool, actually. So, this is the third provider I wanted to talk about. Next week, July 15, we are actually going public preview. And then we are always looking for customer feedback and then feature requests. We are always looking for them. So, we would like request our customers to try this out. And
well, if I may, I'm noticing in your tabs here, that's a GitHub icon. I don't think about SAP and open source, but it looks like, is this open source?
So this, the provider parts that we showed here, everything, that's all open source, actually. So if you go here, so you will see all the logic that we write to collect the telemetry.
That's great.
The users can come here and basically see what we are running to get those telemetry. So this part is, open source. And you can see what we are collecting. So this is pretty cool, this part. Yeah.
That is pretty cool. So then on that next tab, you said that you're going public preview and you want to hear from folks. They can go to that location. We'll put links in the show notes and learn all about the architecture of this, designing your own, and really monitoring all aspects that you care about your solutions.
Yeah. So they can come here, learn about a solution. It gives you like an idea of what it does and then the high level architecture. And it also talks about the current providers that we support, the workbooks that I showed you with the visualization. And it kind of tries to do like a deep dive into each provider type and their capabilities.
Yeah. Fantastic. Well, I've learned a whole bunch of stuff today. Thank you so much for spending time with me.
Thank you so much, Scott, for having me.
All right. We've been learning all about Azure Monitor for SAP Solutions, deploying resources to collect end-to-end telemetry all in one place today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.